In this project, we're making a custom keypad in the shape of a lemon. This keypad uses mechanical switches with 3D printed keycaps fitted on top. It's set up to be a USB keypad for controlling your media like iTunes or Spotify. It uses the HID library for CircuitPython so we can do keystrokes and macros. The electronics are housed in a 3D printed case with all the parts snap fitting together. This Adafruit Cutie Pie features the RP2040 chip from the Raspberry Pi Foundation. It's a tiny CircuitPython board with 11 GPIO, 8 megs of flash, and a StemmaQT connector. Paired with mechanical switches, we think it's the perfect board for your small keyboard projects. The keycaps feature little posts that are press-fitted into the stem of the mechanical switch. It's compatible with any Cherry MX or Kale switch, so you can use the ones you like. The code for this project uses the USB HID library for CircuitPython written by Dan Halbert. The buttons are listed in an array with the pin names matching the GPIO. The key commands are listed in another array with the pins ordered chronologically. Key presses are printed in the REPL so you can plot each switch to your desired key code. With CircuitPython, it's really easy to make custom USB HID projects. Check out the Learn Guide for everything you need to build this project. You can get the code and libraries by downloading the project bundle. It's the big blue button right above the code embed. BundleFly will grab all of the code and libraries, but also any project files like fonts and images. All of the files are bundled in a single zip, so you'll have everything you need to run the code. The board shows up like a USB drive, so you can just drag and drop all the files. Thanks, BundleFly. We designed the enclosure in Fusion 360. If you'd like to modify the design or make your own, we have 3D models available to download from GitHub. Using the fuzzy skin feature in the Cura slicing software, you can give your models a really nice texture. With fuzzy skin only on the outside, you can make sure the internal walls are kept nice and smooth. We used yellow PLA filament, but you'll be happy to know all of the parts can be 3D printed without any supports. So next time life gives you lemons, we hope you're inspired to try CircuitPython.